Good afternoon, children. Today we are going to start the next operator, relational operator. Before, first we have done the operator, arithmetic operator. After this, we are going to start relational operator. Relational operator refer to the relationship that value or operand can have with one another. The relational operator determine the relation among different operand. What are the operand? If A plus B, so A and B are operand and plus is operator. Java provides six relational operator. You are seeing the first is less than, then greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to, equal to and not equal to. These relational expression result always comes in Boolean, either true or false. In equal to, one thing I am going to explain you children, there are two things. One is single equal, one is double equal. What is single equal? That is known as assigning statement or assigning operator. When we are assigned the value like A equal 5, so 5 is assigned in A, so that is assigning operator. Here equal is when we are going to check the relation of two operand A equal equal B, so this is relational operator. So question must become, what is the difference between single equal and double equal? After this, the next is relational operator. How we are going to use the symbol less than equal to? If the values are 0 and 1, so it is true. When the this one is false. If the value is 1, 0, so it is the first is false, the second is also false, the third is false, but it is true. Then 2 and 6, just like this one is true, this one is also true, but this one is false because both the values are different. Then it is also false, but it is not equal, so it is true. So these are used in the program when we start with decision making chapter. These are all operators are used in between the program. The next is logical operator. Relational operator often are used with logical operator. These are also known as conditional operator to construct more complex decision making expression. So these logical operator and this symbol is there, double and, or and not. You can see these in your keyboard. How to write it? What is a format? A is more than B within bracket and sign, then A is more than C. The next is or, A equal equal or A double equal C. And this one is not. But remember children, precedence of operators, one table is giving in your book. You will see how to solve these expression. So if the expression is written like this, the first is, it is solved not, the second is solved and, and third is solved or. Clear? You will see in this table. After logical operator, how to use these logical operator? Operand 1 and operand 2. If operand 1 and operand 2 are both are true, so but it will, operand 2 is evaluated only if operand 1 is true, otherwise both will be true. Then next is either operand 1 or operand 2 is true, then it is evaluated. Here in single is there, both are evaluated, always evaluated according to condition. After logical operator, this table is showing shorthand assignment operator. How to use the shorthand operator? If it is written in between the program like this, operand 1 plus equal operand 2, it is equivalent to operand 1 equal to operand 1 plus operand 2. So if you write it like this, then it is correct. The same is here, all of you see. You will write it first, you are going to write the symbol and then you are going to write the equal. So it is equivalent to this shorthand assignment operator. After shorthand assignment operator, we are going to explain you parameter programming. What is parameter programming? Before this, you have done assigning statement. But in parameter programming, I am giving you some program. You will see the question is, write a program, enter marks of 5 subject. Find out the total and average of marks. Before assigning a statement, it is written there, assign the marks of 5 subjects. So you are going to assign it like M1 equals to 50, M2 equals to 30, like this. But here you are going to enter it. You and me are users. When users are going to enter it. So first we are going to write it import java.io.*. Import java io means input and output. All are in lowercase, then .io.*. You are going to write this package, that is import java is the package name. Then class, you can use curly braces afterwards or end of the statement. Then public, static void, you can write it. I have already explained you, static is optional, either you write it or no. Public void, 5 subjects are there, so A, B, C, D, E. We have integer, all are integer, marks are there, so it is INT. Then curly braces, find out the total and average. So total equals to A plus B plus C, humne total kar liya, and total is going to stored in the variable, that is total. Then average, total divided by 5, it is calculated average. So variables are, identifiers are total and AVG. Then we are going to print it, system.out.println, total is equal to sign plus total, to whatever total calculated, it is total. The next is average, so it is going to calculate the average. Clear? When you compile this program in your computers, all of you see one red box comes in the left side. There it is written, you are going to click it there and give the marks of 5 subject. After that, again in enter in the compile, then you will see the output. After this, the next is write, enter radius of a circle, find out the circumference and the area of a circle. First we are use the package, then class name, then radius of a circle. So radius we input it, double area, then we are use the formula 22/7 divided by R divided by R. R is radius, it is input. Then circle, and after it we are print area and circumference. Clear? The next is write a program, input the principal amount and time and rate. Find the simple interest. Why I have given this program again? Because in assignment statement you have already done. But in this parameter, how, what is the difference between assigning and parameter? That is why I have given you. So you will type this program in the computer and check it. So INTP is your principal, rate and time. All the three we inputted. Then INTSI. We can also use double data type. SI divided by 100 multiplied and divided by, so it is going to calculate simple interest is, and then S. So all these three programs you type it in your computers and then you can see the output. After that, I have given you assignment questions, children. These assignment questions you can write it. The first is WAP that calculates sum and average of four numbers using parameter. So in this you are going to use it for subject marks average and then calculate sum and average. Clear? Then next is the same with, you can see which I have given you in parameter programming, the same is the here. This is area 4 pi r square is there. Clear? It is giving the formula. You calculate the area, input the area in a parameter. After that, you calculate the radius. Radius 7 and then area equals to 4 pi r square. Then next is calculate the area of a rectangle whose length is 17 and width is 23. This also giving you formula. You solve this assignment. One more thing, children. In your computers, there is no project. You are going to make one file that is known as programming file. In that programming file, 15 programs you will write it. How to write the program? First, you are going to write the question, problem, then next program, and then on next video, I will explain you how to write the variable description. So, assignment question, in each video, I will give you, this is the programming file question. I write it. You start writing all the questions. So when 15 questions are completed, then we take your file and your internal assessment is based on that programming file. Your 100 marks internal assessment on your question, computer application in class 10th, it is 200 marks, 100 mark theory paper and 100 internal marks. It is based on 50 marks of your classwork performance, your homework assignments and 50 marks of your programming file. In that 50 marks, you have to write 15 programs related to each and every chapter. So from the next chapter, when I give you assignment, I write in one question. This is your programming file question. So you can write that question in your file. Clear? Okay, children.